असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय सर्वेषां स्वस्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां पूर्णं भवतु सर्वेषां मंगलं भवतु लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
सर चेयरमैन सर फ्लोर इज योर्स।
थैंक यू मधु। गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मंथली लेक्चर सीरीज वाज स्टार्टेड इन नवंबर 2019 एंड देयर वर फिजिकल इवेंट्स बीइंग हेल्ड इन द कॉन्फ्रेंस हॉल ऑफ बीआई ऑफिस इन तारदेव मुंबई। आफ्टर अबाउट 5 लेक्चर्स केम द पेंडेमिक एंड द बीआई मुंबई सेंटर लॉस्ट नो टाइम इन टेकिंग द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑनलाइन। टुडे we are into the 17th lecture in the series, and I am happy to state that we have ICICI Bank partnering with us for this lecture. A construction company as a contractor on a construction project is obliged to supply a bank guarantee for the purpose and timely completion of the work, and a bank guarantee for the quality of the work over the duration of the warranty period for both public and private investors based on contractual conditions. There are a lot of issues faced by contractors when they go to the bank for availing a bank guarantee, like margins, collateral securities, etc. Today we will be hearing from the keynote speakers, Sri Balbir Singh, Product Manager, ICICI Bank, on the latest trends in availing the bank guarantee and the options available. We will be also hearing Sri Riyaz Alam, Chief Manager in Trade Finance in ICICI Banks. He'll be speaking on initiate import payments and regularize bill of entry digitally. Shri Balbir Singh Ji and Shri Riyaz Alam Ji, welcome you both to the event. We have with us today our own Shri Neeru Parma, Vice President BI, who is also Senior Vice President Contracts and Procurements at Chapuji Balaji Real Estate. We hope to hear from him also on this topic. Shri Neeru Parma ji, I welcome you also to the event. I welcome our national secretary Shri Pradeep Nagvekar ji, who has joined us for attending this webinar. We also have senior functionaries from BI who are attending this function. I welcome them all. I welcome all the participants who have registered and are attending today's webinar. After the keynote address during the question and answer session, questions will have been sent in the Google registration form will be taken up first. Thereafter, the questions raised in the chat box, and then participants can raise their hands using the facility in the app and ask their question in person. I wish you all a very informative session. Jai Jai Maharashtra. Now I request our Vice President to give the opening remarks.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for giving me this opportunity to be present at this function and speaking, giving the opening remarks. It's my pleasure and honor. And whenever BI Mumbai Center is hosting any event, it's a great thing indeed, because we lay the foundation and we lay the tread and path for other centers who look upon us as trendsetters. I think this I have to congratulate you and your predecessor, Mr. Gyan, who had started this lecture series. And today we are at the junction where we need more of such lectures to enlighten our members, to enlighten the distinguished personalities who come in close to us, interact on this. And this is, let me tell you, this is a very good platform where we are bringing in people from the industry who can cater to us for our requirements. At the same time, it means a business to them. So it's a win-win situation for us. And Mumbai Center is doing a wonderful job by creating this platform, bringing those two stakeholders very close to each other. That is one aspect. Today we are speaking on the ICICI Bank and its speakers, Mr. Balbir Singh and his colleague, coming up for presentation on few features of bank guarantee. I think which they would be able in a better position to explain that. I won't go into that part. As a contracting companies, our members, developers, day in, day out, we're looking at bank guarantees, which is a secured instrument. Today, it has become so vital for everybody to do function with a bank guarantee that it is indispensable in any maze. Earlier, there were only contractors who were submitting bank guarantees for the mobilization advance to the government departments or to any client for that matter. But with the passage of time, due to the performance issues of the contractor, they have started coming up with performance bank guarantee, which has now become a very, very integral part of all the contracts. And developers have not left behind. They also started putting in performance bank guarantee, very popularly known as PBG. Now, since these things have come into place, so we need more clarity, more assurance to the members to get it. Earlier, those contractors who have been working since many years, they were getting an easy access to get to the guarantees, bank guarantees. They had their limits sanctioned at a very easily and attainable collateral securities, which they might have given it in the yesteryears. Today, contractors are finding it very, very difficult as banks have changed their norms over the years to lend bank guarantee. And more importantly, without which the contractor is not able to function. So my request to the ICICI team, and specifically to Mr. Balbir Singh, who is spearheading this event, is anyways, you are going to come up with the digitalization aspect of bank guarantee, how you are functioning in the COVID era. That all is very much appreciated. I would appreciate if you can dwell more and have a food for thought with respect to aspects, how to ease the eligibility criteria of the contractors to get the bank guarantee. You will be definitely taking us through the procedural aspect of the bank guarantee. That is absolutely fine. That will be a nice thing to listen to. But if you can raise the eligibility criteria, make it more friendly to the contractors, to the parties who are using it, I think that will go a long way. And I assure you that all the members who are logged in here today and other members who have, due to some reason, missed out, will be always looking at ICICI if they could come up with some specific products in BGs and giving concessions to the contractors. Of course, you can follow your norms with respect to secured securities which you want to take it. But relaxation will give you more business. As a part of BI, I would like to say that. And speed of issuance of BG is going to be definitely a very, very big criteria. Another aspect which I would like to take up on this is, normally what we see is the issuance of bank guarantee. Till the submission of bank guarantee, it takes easily 2 weeks time. When the client is ready with the money, but he will not give it. Two aspects. One is with the bank, that is the issuance part and their internal procedures. Second most important aspect is the format of the bank guarantee. Now, quite often we see whenever the bank guarantee is submitted to the client, there will be always suggestions, improvements, or changing certain grammatical aspects. Let me tell you, there are no material changes in the bank guarantee formats given by the banks or given by the contractors. It is just the grammatical aspects. So I would request the ICICI team to come up with a format which is a sort of tailor-made, and it gets through the department, and the format is vetted by the client at the earliest. So on one hand, you are saving the time due to digitalization. On the other hand, if you can shorten the format part of it, I think that would squeeze the issuance of bank guarantee to 2 to 3 days, or say 4 days at the most. That would help the contractors in getting the money back. I mean, getting their advances against the bank guarantee. And lastly, before I just part, I think we all are very much accustomed with the slogan KYC, which all the banks always asks customers to give all the KYC, give all the documents. But let me tell you, here there is an opportunity that today we are having a KYB. So we are saying, know your bank. That's what ICICI team is coming and telling us, know your bank, what we are capable of, what we can extend you, what facilities we can provide. So I think we are more keen to listen, to understand that what should be the KYB and how our KYB is better than your competitors in the market. I think I won't come in between your presentation. So I throw the back open to you and hand it over to the chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. Sri Neera Parmaji. You have very nicely set the tone for the evening. We will now hear Sri Balbir Singh. And before that, I would like to inform that you that Sri Balbir Singh is an Assistant General Manager at Allied Trade Relations Group, ICICI Bank. He has over 20 years of experience in banking industry with 15 years in trade. Our second speaker for the evening, who will be speaking on initiate input payments and regularize bill of entry digitally, is Sri Riyaz Alam. Sri Riyaz Alam is Chief Manager in Trade Finance at ICICI Bank. He is a banking professional with 14 plus years of experience in banking sector, which includes transaction banking, trade and forex, sales and operations, and retail banking. And 3+ years of experience in manufacturing sector prior to joining banking sector in finance and account division. Now I request Balbir Singh ji to take over. Madhu?
Yeah, Balbir Singh ji, your camera is problem.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes. You're audible. What about your camera?
Can you switch on your camera, please?
My laptop camera is not working, so I have connected through mobile. Am I visible, sir?
No, you are not visible.
Your picture is visible, I suppose.
Anyway, Balbir Singh ji, you have colleagues with us because if one of your colleagues goes through the chat questions simultaneously, so that it will be easier to take it up when we have the question answer session.
Yeah, I'll do that, sir.
You can start your presentation, and you are not visible, but I think you are going to screen share.
Praveer, can you put up the presentation?
ठीक है ना अरे सुन मैं निकलू ना अभी मैं निकलू ना कैमरा बंद करके निकलू
कैन वी स्टार्ट सर
यस सर यू कैन स्टार्ट
थैंक यू चेयरमैन सर थैंक यू नीरव सर एंड वार्म गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल सीनियर डिग्निटरीज एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आईसीआईसीआई बैंक सर आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू थैंक यू So, for giving us this opportunity to present our products. So, bank guarantee, sir, as you mentioned it rightly, it looks complex product, but it's actually a very simple product. It has been understood in a way that it looks complex. But over the years, I have seen, sir, myself, I have experienced when I started my career in banking. It took a week's time to get a BG issue. Now we are talking about BG issuing over the counter, sir. We are not very far away by doing coming out with some proposition like that. Currently, we say we do it in 3 hours. That's how you will shortly see our print media campaign also revolving around this theme of 3 hour bank guarantee, sir. Starting with bank guarantee, Praveer, if you can move on to the next slide, please. So bank guarantee is a lifeline of most of the businesses, sir, especially the infrastructure business, if you talk about. Where everything works on bank guarantee, and this bank guarantee actually helps the business grow leaps and bounds. So just to be, you would be aware about the definition, but I thought this is how we start and we talk about what a bank guarantee is. It's nothing but a assurance given by a bank on behalf of its customer to an external party that could be, that is a beneficiary, that would help increase their business. That is how, in brief, if I have to tell you about a bank guarantee, which you would be aware. So there are three parties involved in bank guarantee: the applicant, the beneficiary, and the applicant, beneficiary, and the bank, which acts as a guarantor on behalf of its customers. So why bank guarantees are required? It adds creditworthiness. It gives the confidence to the beneficiary that the contractor or the vendor is able to perform. It also gives a view about the assessment that the customer, the contractor has over the business. It gives a comfort to the beneficiary on the risk appetite, so that they know that there is a fallback in case in case of any eventuality. So moving on to the next. These are some of the key requirements that we have picked up, sir, while speaking to a lot of customers. Why bank guarantee is important? Bank guarantee is a time-bound requirement because there is a deadline. It is not that it is at the convenience of the bank or the customer to submit a bank guarantee. There is a tender backed by certain timelines within which the bank guarantee needs to be presented. Otherwise, there is a risk of a financial loss or losing the contract as well. Ease and convenience matters a lot, sir. Customers look at ease and convenience because they do not want what Nirav sir had also told, that the text part is actually a complex which takes a lot of time because there are a lot of errors and a lot of grammatical mistakes that needs to be corrected. So that also, that is where this ease and convenience matters. Document should be simple. When the bank is offering a bank guarantee, it should not have a lengthy set of documents. So that is where when we try to ease on those documents. And second, sir, the processing actually should be very, very convenient. It should not take time for a bank to issue a bank guarantee. These are some of the aspects that a customer looks for when they come for a bank guarantee. Acceptance is another aspect which they look at it. A bank guarantee should be widely accepted across all government and private beneficiaries. So sometimes they come back and tell, we need it from X bank, we need it from a scheduled bank, we need it from a PSU bank. So that is one additional aspect we have noted out here. Then the important aspect also is the pricing that matters. It should not be priced in such a way that it actually looks quite exorbitant. So pricing also plays an important role when it comes to availing bank guarantee services. So these are some key aspects. Moving on to what we have at ICICI Bank, sir. ICICI Bank, if we talk about our product on bank guarantees, the most important thing that we say is we give bank guarantees under 3 hours. That has been our theme for the last 2 years, and we are able to deliver 80-85% of our bank guarantees under 3 hours. Some may get delayed because of some text related or other aspects where we actually have to go back to the customer and ask for some additional information. But majority of our requests that comes from customers get issued under 3 hours. Knowing that the bank guarantee is a time-bound requirement and it needs to be submitted to the beneficiary on time. That's the reason this is what we understood. The essence is time in the entire transaction. Express processing, the theme, the word that we have coined out here is basis that requirement only. Why? Because, sir, what we have observed the contractor does all other activities prior to going to the bank and asking for a bank guarantee. Bank guarantee is the last thing that the contractor starts working on because he feels this is something that needs capital and it should be done at the last point of the in the last mile of that particular transaction. So that's where the going to the bank is the last thing that they want to do, and any delay there would have an impact on the outcome of the project itself. So that's the reason we wanted to keep it tight and see that the bank guarantee gets issued in the defined turnaround time. Single visit fulfillment, what it tells is, if you look at, sir, as we move on to the next slides, I'll tell you how the product has actually evolved over a period of time, because it required multiple visits to a bank to get a bank guarantee, submitting a request, then if it's a fixed deposit, discharge, then going and collecting bank guarantee, all that involved multiple steps. So that is where we try to address that and eliminate it. We talk about single visit fulfillment, so that you go once and you get your bank guarantee. Documentation, earlier there were sets of documents that the customer need to sign despite having an account with the bank. So that's where we try to keep an application very simple, 2 to 3 pages. And so that it is not complex and not with multiple fields, which a user need to actually search and think, what is that I need to fill? Submit online and collect from branch. This is our online proposition, trade online, sir, what we call our product, wherein you can, it's a comprehensive product which has got almost all types of transactions on trade available on one platform. And I could also say it could be the it is the industry's first which has almost all transactions on one platform. BG libraries are coming to the point which Nirav sir had also told, that the text keeps on changing and that's where transactions get delayed. So here what we can do, sir, we can get the text verified, vetted in one go and upload it in the library, so that in case any of the beneficiaries require, any of the applicant requires the BG to be submitted to the same set of beneficiary. If the beneficiary is common, if I have to make it simple, if the beneficiary is common, and I need to submit the bank guarantee, and the text is the beneficiary, suppose, is say L&T, and there we need to submit a standard bank guarantee, and there are 10 different contractors who work for L&T. I'm just taking an example. So once the text of L&T is approved, we can actually use the same text without actually going for the vetting of the text, so that I pick up from the library and I use this bank guarantee text. So it takes out that time that is required to go through the text again and again, because there is a history of BGs being issued against the same text. So that is one thing that we have that is unique to us. Moving on to the final feature, the bank guarantees are available, as you are aware, against a fixed deposit as well as a collateral bank limits. So both facilities are available with the bank to avail a bank guarantee. Moving on to the next slide. So just to take you through a brief, the way the, when I talked about the online issuance, why? Because as I told, the earlier part of getting a bank guarantee, multiple visits are required. We try to do away all these things so that the customer should not, it should not be inconvenient for the customer to have to collect a bank guarantee and visit branch multiple times. So this is where our trade online application comes into play. Once the customer logs into that, applies for a bank guarantee, very simple, user-friendly application. Fill in the fields, beneficiary amount details, expiry date, all those details are there. Once these fields are filled, the text is uploaded, submits it online. Once the customer submits it online on our trade online application, the entire request moves to our operations unit, who in turn will, if it's a limit, the limit is blocked. If it is a fixed deposit is created, a lien on the deposit is marked, then the final bank guarantee PDF file is assigned to the branch. So you only go and collect it from the branch. You need not visit the branch prior to the BG is ready. So you get a notification that the BG is ready, and then you go and visit the branch to collect it. So these all things we are saying will happen in a span of 3 hours or even less. Earlier, some of our customers have even experienced far superior timing. Even under hour, we were able to give. And the good thing about it, sir, we are working 18/6. What do we mean by 18/6? Is our operations unit starts at 6 in the morning and they work till 12 in the night. And this is 6 days a week. We, even if the request is raised at 7:30 p.m. in the evening, we will be able to get this request processed and you get the BG on the same day. So that is something that ICICI only does in today's date. There are other banks which have got certain cutoff time. So this is unique about ICICI Bank, sir. Below that, I had just shown you the process that talks about how the conventional method of bank guarantee issuance was there. You can move on to the next, please. So this is one circular issued by Reserve Bank of India, sir, because sometimes we come across instances where the beneficiary insists that the BG should be from a public sector bank only. So whereas RBI has very clearly and categorically clarified and also issued a circular mentioning that the all government departments should accept a bank guarantee from any scheduled commercial bank. So this actually eased a lot of restrictions from the beneficiaries. Basis this circular, which is available on the RBI website, the reference number is also available. So we quote this wherever the government entity says, no, we need it from a PSU bank. So this helps us get our bank guarantees accepted by most government departments. Yeah, we can move on to the next. Related to this, sir, we have a GEM account. GEM, this GEM current account is exclusive to the contractor segment, where they are supplying, they are contractors to the government, they are vendors to the government. So this current account comes with absolutely no MAB requirement. That means there is no requirement to maintain a minimum balance in the account, and the host of other features that are linked to this account, like if I talk about deposit backed limits, third party, because certain contractors requires fixed deposits to be given in the name of third parties, so that like the municipal corporation accepts deposits in a smaller cities instead of bank guarantee. So that is also there. There is a debit card limit that gets enhanced on this. Cash management services, like in case you have a cash pickup or cash delivery at your doorstep. So all that can be provided under this GEM current account. This is exclusive for the contractor segment, sir. And this comes with host of benefits. One of the key, as I told you, sir, is no requirement of maintaining an average balance in the current account. So that gives a lot of comfort to the account holder. Yeah, so there we come on to the end. So before we move on to this, if I had seen a chat in the chat box, which they were asking about a claim period, sir. If I can answer it now, or should I answer it, Nirav sir, after the session is complete? Should I answer?
Yeah, you can answer.
Yeah. So there was a question on claim period. So I tell you, sir, claim period is one question which most of us have, most of the applicants have, because there it comes from a government regulation, that is an Indian Contract Act, Section 28, Exception 3, which talks about a claim period. What should be a claim period? So claim period says it's a minimum 1 year. This is a 2013 guideline, bank started implementing from 2019 onwards, because IBA had issued a guideline to all the banks to follow the claim period norms. So what it says, sir, there is a law of limitation under there is a limitation act. Basis that it is defined that any contract should have certain cooling off period. Once the contract is completed, there should be sufficient time for the beneficiary to have a recourse. So that is where this 1 year claim period comes into picture. All bank guarantees today, if you look at, comes with a mandatory claim period of 1 year. So that's where even the bank follows, ICICI Bank also follows the same norm when it comes to claim period. So all BGs that we issue necessary comes with 1 year, 1 year claim period, sir. In case the original bank guarantee and the discharge letter is received prior to that, the BG can be closed. If the BG is not received or the discharge letter is not received after the expiry of the bank guarantee, the BG will continue to be remain in force for a period of 1 year. So that is the rule, sir. This is the Contract Act. I just look at, this is Section 28, sir. So it is not 23, Section 28 Indian Contract Act. It is mentioned here. It will allow encashment after a lapse of validity period. So claim period, I said, sir, after expiry, even if the BG expiry is of say 1 year and there is no claim period, certain banks give, but the beneficiary has the right, even if it is not mentioned in the text, up to 1 year from the date of expiry to go and claim from the issuing bank basis can file an invocation request with the issuing bank asking for a payment. So there, even there are certain High Court and Supreme Court rulings in favor of the beneficiary where they had given the order in favor of the beneficiary asking the bank to pay, even though the text did not have that particular requirement. So there is one more query. Is there any RBI circular or notification that BG Commission will be charged for a period of 2-1 our validity of BG plus 1 year once client returns the original BG? So when it comes to the commercial aspects of any products, sir, RBI does not mention about what charges the bank should charge. So that is for the bank to decide, and there is every bank has got its own policy of having charges. So there is no RBI circular. Whereas when it comes to us, sir, we do not charge for the claim period upfront, but we for a fixed deposit bank guarantee, there is no charges for claim period if you have not specified. So we do not charge anything for the claim period. Whereas if it's a limit-backed bank guarantee issued against the limits, we do not charge upfront. We charge only after the expiry in case you are not able to submit the original bank guarantee or a discharge letter. So this is Sudhakar sir had asked this question. I move on to the next. So there is, what after the BG is expired and claim period is also expired? So after the BG, Chirag Gandhi sir had asked a question, what of the BG is expired and claim period is expired? Once the BG and the claim period is expired, 10 days after the expiry of claim period, the limit is released or the FD is released from the bank and the BG is closed in the systems. So these are some of the questions related to bank guarantee. We can, if you allow us, we can move on. So there is another, what is the minimum margin to avail BG from ICICI Bank after availing limit? So that depends, basis the assessments are once the limit is sanctioned at the time of giving a CAL, it talks about the margin money that needs to be maintained in a form of fixed deposit. That could vary anything from 5 to 15, 20, 30% also, sir, depending on the credit assessment of the company, sir. So with this, sir, I come to an end of bank guarantees. If there are any questions in the chat, I can take it up and we can move on to the next session. When original BG is returned, why commission is charged for a period for original date return? When original BG, so the day you return the BG, there is no commission charged. If there is any prepaid commission at ICICI Bank, we refund that commission, sir, so that provision is there with ICICI Bank. The day you return, if the commission is prepaid for any further period, that can be, that would be refunded. So now I invite Mike.
So would you like to take the question? Raise
the hand. Yeah, let him also finish his presentation now.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. So I invite my colleague Riaz Alam to take us through the import-export solutions that we have on from ICICI Bank. Over to you, Riaz.
Riaz is there. He has a presentation, or he's going to come on the screen? Acha, Riaz, yeah. Riaz, unmute yourself.
Hi, good afternoon. Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, we can hear you, sir. Please care.
So hi, a very warm welcome to all of you from on behalf of ICICI Bank. So first of all, I would like to thank Builders Association of India and our chairman, sir, Mr. Mohinder ji, and Nirav sir for giving ICICI Bank this opportunity to speak with all the participants. So I'll be basically taking you through the basic guidelines of the import transactions, how to regularize your bill of entry, and what are the digital offerings that ICICI Bank offers, especially for the importers for your trade transactions. So we can move on to the next slide, Praveen. Yeah. So while we have been interacting with the importers and exporters and all the trade bodies across the country, wherein we have basically come to see that there are three kinds of a major problem which the customers face. First, they run against the time to submit documents in the branch. Like the branch has closing hours either at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4. So they were bound that any transactions pertaining to any trade transactions, or it be like issuance of a bank guarantee or any import export, it has to be submitted within the bank, and the representative had to visit and wait at the branch for his turn to submit the document and get the transaction executed. Sometimes we also saw that at the branch, if there is a change of relationship manager or the transaction processing manager, or if there's somebody new representative coming from the company, they get lost in the branch, like whom to contact, whom to approach, which decks to get these transactions done. And also one very common request from all the importers basically, and those traders for trade transactions, where an outward remittance is made, a swift copy is required by them to enable them to send it to their overseas party, confirming that the payment has been made so that the necessary shipments can be done. Now, in order to cater all these three kinds of, to resolve these three kinds of basic problems, ICICI Bank has a very unique offering, which is known as Trade Online. So Praveer, you can change the slide, please. Yeah. So Trade Online is one of the unique offering of ICICI Bank, a digital platform wherein you don't need to visit the branch to initiate transactions. It can be initiated at the comfort of your home or office anytime, anywhere. So if you can see on the screen, like almost all the trade transactions, right, from domestic, be it a domestic trade or an export-import trade, everything can be executed on our Trade Online platform. So on the import side, you can make import bill payments, you can regularize your import bills, you can get your LC issued, you can make service payments, any A2 payments, anything which needs to be done to an overseas party. On the export side, you can settle your inward remittances on your own. You can request for export credit, that is EPC packing credit, either in INR or foreign currency, provided you have the sanction. And you can regularize your export bills as well. And of course, you can also get your bank guaranteed issued the way just now Balbir has mentioned in his previous slides. So to tell you, like, this is a unique offering with no additional cost on the customer. It's totally free, no setup cost, nothing, no annual maintenance charges, nothing. Totally paperless, and transactions initiated through Trade Online have a much faster turnaround time because it reduces the branch leg of the transactions. You don't need to visit any branch. And the best part is, whatever transactions you initiate through Trade Online, you can have the complete audit trail of all the transactions initiated. So on just one platform, you can have the view of all your import, export, trade related transactions. And this will also help you in your audit in completing your own audit requirements. So what are the features? First, it is safe and secure with robust authentication processes, auto generation of regulatory documents, like if any confirmation or anything is there, it gets auto generated. We have a complete dashboard of stage wise pending. So I'll show you in my next slides what are the dashboard it offers. Then we have pre-filled templates. So for example, for the same beneficiary, you don't need to repeat and fill up the forms all over again. You can save it and just change the amount and the relevant field where you want to change and get and submit the request. Then there's an intimation to beneficiary once the payment is done. And the best part also is you can schedule future payments. So for say, for example, you will be traveling, you want to make an outward remittance on say Monday, but since you will be traveling, you will not be able to access due to network connectivity or anything. You can schedule it at all your transactions at a future date, and it will get executed on its own. Change the slide, please. Yeah. So as I was mentioning about the dashboard, so you can see we have a complete transaction compliance dashboard wherein you can see the transaction status. Like on the left hand side, if you see the table, what transactions are in process in the bank, whether any inward remittance you have received and it is pending for settlement. Similarly, if you have done any export transactions or if you have submitted any bills which is yet to be realized, or you have already done the shipment, payment is yet to be received, or you have received an advance but you have not done the shipment for export transactions. Similarly, on the import, like if you have received any bills and if you have not paid or accepted, that will show here. So your entire transactions, including inland transactions, like inland collection bill, inland bills for due, if you have done any LCBD, that is bill discounting backed by LC issued within India. So all your trade compliance transactions, you will get an entire dashboard here at just the click of a button. Moreover, if you click each level, each item, then a detailed view can also be viewed. So just go on to the next, Praveen. Yeah. So see, suppose if you are an importer and doing import, so you need to submit the bill of entry to the bank so that the bank regularizes your entry and updates the RBI portal known as IDPMS. Because once you do the outward remittance against your IEC, it gets reflected on the RBI's portal IDPMS as an outstanding item wherein the money has gone outside India and the corresponding import is pending. So once the import is done, again that IC, the bill of entry will be issued, and that bill of entry, whatever items are pending for whichever import you have done, whether it is an advance remittance import, whether you have done or on a collection bill, everything will be reflected here along with the bill of details and whether it is outstanding for less than 90 days or more than 90 days. Because as RBI says, within 90 days, we have to get the imports done. Maximum up to 180 days and submit the bill of entry to the bank. So on the right hand side, you can see the table. It will show you a dashboard, what is total pending and what is overdue and what is within within the due date period, that is within 90 days. So you get an entire details of the bill of entry that is pending. So this take care of your regulatory aspects, and you do not default on the FEMA compliances in case you are making some import transactions. So you can also, you know, through this dashboard can have a real time tracking of your transactions. Suppose if you have sent any request to the bank, whether the transaction is processed, initiated, pending at which desk, it will show the current status, and accordingly you can connect with your branch or inform your overseas party that the transaction is at the branch and lying at this station. Once completed, it will show that the transaction has been processed. So almost a real-time tracking of the transactions can be done through this customer OneView dashboard. So you can also initiate outward remittances transactions, basically for import or any A2 make payments. Like you can do an advance or direct import bill payments. You have the option to debit your current account, or if you're maintaining an EFC account, that is exchange earners foreign currency account, you can directly give instructions to debit your EFC account in dollar or whichever currency you are maintaining and do the remittance. The necessary forms which you need to submit, which in physically to the branch. So through Trade Online, you don't need to submit anything in physical. All the regulatory documents like, FEMA declaration, negative list declaration, and A2 request letter, everything gets auto-generated once you submit the transaction. You also, get the exchange rates online through our portal called FX Online, which can be integrated with this Trade Online. This is highly secured. There is no manual intervention and very much streamlined processes. with very easy steps wherein you can also depute your representative to initiate the transactions and you verify it as a second step. And apart from all above, you don't need to visit the branch for making an outward remittance. So what are the steps? How do you do it on online? You just need to log in with your credentials, go to Trade Online, select the remittance that you want to make, put the applicant details and beneficiary details, the remittance details, that is remittance amount, beneficiary account number, everything. Then you upload the necessary documents like an invoice, purchase order, or anything which is required for that transaction, and submit, and your transaction is gone for is submitted to the bank for further processing. So one aspect which I told you, that bill of entry, which is very important to be submitted to the bank. So previously, what was happening, the importer used to visit the bank with the physical copy, exchange control copy of bill of entry, submit a written declaration with a covering letter, give to the bank, and then bank used to regularize it in earlier days. Now, since everything is moving on to the digital platform, now once the bill of entry gets generated, it gets reflected against that particular IEC on the IDPMS portal, RBI's IDPMS portal. So from there, again, that particular IC, all your outstanding bill of entry will get reflected on your Trade Online platform with the numbers. Similarly, whatever remittances you do from your account and against that particular IC, that will also get reflected here on the Trade Online platform. Now, since you have to regularize the transaction, that is, inform the bank that again, this particular import payment, the necessary import has been done, and this is the bill of entry. Both will appear on your screen. That is, you can see on the screen, we have shown it on a pictorial way. The remittances that you do is there on the left-hand side in orange color, and the bill of entry, which is get generated by the customs, is reflected on the right-hand side. So you just need to do the match the following. That is, again, which remittance, which bill of entry number needs to be adjusted. And you just need to submit the transaction and that's it. Your bill of entry gets regularized. Your outward remittance transactions also gets closed. And at the same time, the banks are the RBI's portal IDPMS also gets updated that, again, this particular remittance, the import has been done. And the bill of entry is duly received. So it is as simple as that. So as Balbir has mentioned, like we have a different trade hub working almost for 18 hours at different time zones. You do not get limited by the banking hours to submit the transactions. You can initiate your transactions almost anytime during the day and submit to the bank. So once within the transactions time, it will get processed. So you don't have to wait for the branch to open at 9:30 and 10, or rush to the branch within the closing time 2, 4, or 3:30, whatever is the time. So you have the flexibility now to initiate your transaction almost 24 hours in a day. So apart from this, on the digital thing that we have just mentioned, we have a large dedicated team across the country. So specifically for trade transactions, we have specialized trade teams in the branches, which consists of the trade desk manager and trade service managers. Then we have on the field, on the ground, we have the relationship team, followed by regional head, sales and regional head. And at the zonal level, we have the zonal heads. Also, to assist you in your foreign exchange dealings and to offer you the best exchange rates and for advisory functions, we have treasury team at the local level. And at the central level, we have the product team designated specifically for each of your product requirements. And we also have subject matter experts to help you and guide you with respect to regulatory compliances and various other compliances with respect to trade transactions, and guide you in your critical transactions and provide you solutions. So we have more than just go back once. Yeah, so we have more than 500 specialized branches, more than 1100 specialized relationship managers, followed by treasury and a large branch network. So you have the convenience of both digital as well as the branch footprint. We also have, you know, for specifically for corporate customers, wherein you can do almost 115 business banking transactions through an app. So this was almost an industry first. This was an industry first development wherein ICICI Bank came up with a mobile app known as InstaBiz, wherein through one banking app, you can almost do 115 transactions, settle your inward remittances, get auto bank reconciliations, everything. And it is almost also role-based access with enhanced features. So if you want to give to someone like with restricted features and all, that can also be done. So just like on the saving side, we have a mobile apps for doing personal transactions. On the business side, we have InstaBiz app for doing your business transactions. So that's it from my side. So we have come almost to the end of this presentation. So these are some of the awards that our bank has won by way of providing, you know, doing digital innovations and other product innovations. And we continue to do so such product and digital innovations so that our customers get the value, and we minimize your time, which needs to be done in banking, and you devote more time to your own business and bother less on getting your banking transactions executed basically through our digital platforms. So thank you very much for a patient hearing, and we can now have the question and answers specifically on import, export, or anything on the digital part.
That yeah, we have some people have raised their hands. I think Nagvekar Sahib, you want to speak now or you'd like to go with the concluding remarks? I think Mr. VKJ, can we stop the screen sharing? Hello? Praveen, can we stop the screen sharing? Praveen. Yes, yes. One minute, huh? Mr. Praveer Rao, VK Nika, Rao Raj, unmute yourself, sir. Your question is addressed to whom? Mr. Ram?
I am Krishna Rao, sir.
Now, yeah, please, you have raised your hand. Please ask me the question.
Yes, yes, sir. It is good. The ICICI Bank, my bank also, ICICI Bank, has bring this speed busy system. It is very helpful to the trade, especially to the infrastructure sector. The future, the charges will be made only up to the usage period also. It's a very good offer. And most people will turn to the ICICI Bank for that service. With respect to, I am also facing one BG of mine, where in the original BG, there is no claim period. Later, the claim period has been added by the bank. Considering that is a government norm. It is not a government norm or the RBI norm. It is only under Section 28 of the Contract Act. Earlier, the claim period was 3 years for private BGs and 30 years for the government BGs. The limitation period has been make 1 year only, because if there is a case, the bank has to keep the BGs in life after the validity period. Now that period has been limited to 1 year only. that period is not for making payment to the beneficiary. If the beneficiary submit its invocation letter before the validity period, then the bank will see whether the bank can pay or not to pay as per the terms of the bank guarantee. Once the validity period date has been lapsed, in the claim period, the bank cannot pay. The beneficiary also having no right to demand in the claim period. I'm seeing in some of the ICICI Bank BDs, the bank writing like that. If the beneficiary invoke the bank guarantee within the claim period, then only the bank will pay. It is not correct as per the law. The bank can pay only within the validity period. Validity period, after validity period, bank guarantee will be become dead. Only one deadline will be there. After the validity period, if the beneficiary raises any claim, any suit, no, you have not paid, wrongly not paid, I have a case, then for the beneficiary, 1 year period will be there to file a suit in a court or arbitration. Normally will not be there in bank guarantees. If the beneficiary failed to raise any claim within the 1 year period, bank will be, there is no suit also. Limitation period will be end. Normal business transactions, it is 3 years. For bank guarantee, it is only 1 year claim period, suit period that is. I think in the IndusInd Bank case also, Supreme Court has cleared this. I appreciate if the bank will take into the cognizance of this aspect of the BGs. Thank you.
Mr. Balbir, unmute yourself.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Rao, sir. Whatever you have said is correct. Claim period derives from Section 28 of the Limitation Act, which says there is a year period available to the beneficiary for a recourse from the applicant. So there could be two aspects of it. One, when you are actually issuing a bank guarantee, you have restricted the claim period, say 3 months from the date of expiry. The text says so. Despite the fact that the text is restricting it for 3 months after the expiry, ideally bank should not issue such bank guarantees with a claim period of less than 1 year, but in case it has been accommodated, which we also do in certain cases, there is a recourse for the beneficiary to come back in the balance 9 months. So that is again subject to the legal suits and all, but the window to the beneficiary is during the 12 months period, they have the right to recourse. They can claim the invocation, sir, from the bank. They can raise the invocation demand on the bank. And that is what you have narrated, the IndusInd Bank case. And also there is a PNB versus Cal Computers, which also where the Supreme Court actually given in favor of the beneficiary to make the payment. So this is subject to law, sir. And this also requirement stems from the legal aspects of Contract Act only. There is no guideline which RBI says so. So why? Because bank guarantee is a contract, and the Contract Act would be followed when it comes to bank guarantees.
Mr. I think you are satisfied, Mr. Rao. I think Mr. Nirupan, you had raised your hand. And Krishnani, sir.
Krishnani, Mr. Krishnani wants to speak, sir.
Yeah, but he's not there.
He was there. I saw him. He's there, logged in with two instruments, I suppose.
Yeah, but now he's not there in a single thing also. Nagarkar, sir, you have a question or your con?
No, I have a lot many questions. But let others to finish, because that may be covered by them.
And then I will... participants, gentlemen, ladies, those who have to ask questions, please raise your hand using the app, not on the screen, because we cannot see. You better... Chairman, sir, can you call up Mr. Krishnani? Anyway,
Chairman sir.
You can move on to the next question. He can whenever.
Have the questions in the chat been taken up, Mr. Balbir?
Unmute,
Mr. Balbir. Unmute yourself.
So I had addressed all the queries. There is one Mr. Gautam Mukherjee who has a question on bank guarantee. So Mr. Gautam, you can ask your question, sir, please.
Mr. Gautam, can you raise your hand? Gautam, G-A-U, G-O-U. Mr. Gautam, unmute yourself. Mr. Gautam, unmute.
Yeah, good evening, gentlemen. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. I can hear you, sir.
We have a case. Recently, we have migrated from a PSU bank to ICICI bank for our working capital facilities. Now we are, ICICI bank has extended the facilities to us and we are operating on it. Now, as it happens with the bank guarantees, because our bank guarantees issued by our earlier PSU bank are still locked with the beneficiaries.
Right.
And as per the sanction given by ICICI bank, they have been issuing the bank guarantees in our favor to replace the bank guarantees already issued by the PSU so that we can liquidate our limits with the PSU.
Right, so there is a counter guarantee that could have been issued.
No, sir. This counter guarantee ICICI Bank wanted to give, but PSU has not accepted it.
Okay, sir.
So one by one, we are replacing the PSU bank guarantees by ICICI Bank issued bank guarantees. Okay, now, the point I'm trying to mainly emphasize on the onerous clause in the bank guarantee.
Right, sir. Onerous clause.
Because earlier the bank guarantees issued by the PSU bank and our clients are also PSU, so they want line by line, word by word, same bank guarantee to be issued by ICICI bank.
Right, sir. Right. They don't accept anything in the text.
Yeah, even the notwithstanding clause, which is basically same, but the format between the banks differ.
Right.
Maybe the words differ, paragraphs differ, like that. Now, our clients are saying, no, we want the same exactly as per the given by PSU. Now, ICICI Bank is saying that if you want to change the notwithstanding clause as per our procedures with the whatever has been given by PSU, so it becomes an onerous clause. And in that case, you have to give additional margin. So I would like to know, is this the procedure of ICICI Bank, or is that what we should follow?
Sir, if the NWC is available, that is, what are the three features of NWC? Mm-hmm. The amount is capped, the expiry date is capped, and the location of invocation should be mentioned, sir.
Yeah.
So these are three constituents of NWC.
Yeah.
If all these three are mentioned, though it may not be in a standard format, it can be considered, sir. I do not know why the additional margin requirement has come up. We can look at your case, sir, if you can give us those details separately. We have already given the email ID, sir. I will let us speak to the individual at your location and see what exactly is the requirement for additional margin money, sir. Because as I said, if the three fields are there and all these are covered, it should not be considered onerous. It is a non-standard NWC.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much. In fact, we'll take it up with our ICICI Bank contact, and then we'll because I will write to you to your email ID. And
right. Question, so we have given the email IDs on. If you scroll up, you will see the email IDs.
Yeah. So, but definitely this is going to be an issue with us, because when it comes to bank guarantees, the beneficiaries are very adamant.
No, I understand, sir. PSU entities, government entities, they do not want a single change, even a line here and there in the text what they have issued. So the NWC is a common field you will find in all bank guarantees. But what will happen out here, the way it is mentioned, it differs from beneficiary to beneficiary. So there, the bank has defined there is a certain format that needs to be there at the bottom of the bank guarantee. True. But in case it is different, it is considered a non-standard NWC. But if all the three constituents of that particular NWC are available, sir, it ideally should not be considered as a onerous, sir. We can discuss that separately, sir, once you give us the details.
Yes, sir, INA.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Mr. Krishnan will be joining us shortly. Mr. Nirav Parmar, you want to ask a question? You please shoot.
No, I just wanted to add to that, like regarding what you said, Mr. Balbir, that you discussed about the products and all. We would like to you to take up a session on LC as well as bill discounting, because BG is one aspect where we are giving you money and security, and you're giving us a bank guarantee. We would like, you know, contractors to avail the bill discounting facility. That would bring in, you know, more cash flow, which is badly required during the pandemic time. If you can later on, not today exactly, because today is we are away from that topic, but I would like you to dwell on that and come up with a product which would be a win-win for everybody, and most of the contractors would like to avail that thing. That's my thought on that part.
Oh, nice. Mr. Balbir, Mr. Rao, the person who asked the question, he's writing on chat whether a bank guarantee can, whether a BG can be issued in the name of a company without naming a specific person or designated officer. If given, who can invoke the BG from a company if necessary? It's in the chat. Acha, you have muted yourself. Okay. Unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. So, whether a BG can be issued in the name of a company without a name of a specific person or a designated officer. So, BG is always issued in the name of a company only, sir. It is never issued in any individual name. And when it comes to invocation, anybody who's signing on behalf of that company or the government department, the invocation can be should be handled, sir. We do not question who had sent that letter, because it is there on the letterhead of that particular company, because I do not know who's the authorized signatory there. I would follow that letter and I will proceed with the invocation, sir.
Fair enough. I think Nagarkar, sir.
Some questions have been left in the chat box, previous chats. Kindly go through that. I think one of the questions is from Vijay Shah. What are the eligible criteria for setting up the bank limit? The ICICI Bank in collateral mode forms. Can you brief on this?
What are the eligibility criteria for setting up a BG limit with ICICI Bank on a collateral mode, sir? So we have a credit team. We will arrange for a call. They would look at your financials assessment. They do the assessment. So they have got their own norms, sir, the credit team. So they will, we can take it up with the respective credit team at your location. We can speak to you, look at your financials, and basis that a certain amount is arrived, and we can proceed further on that, sir. What is the amount that can be extended to you, both fund-based and non-fund-based?
Okay.
One more
question is there. What is minimum margin to available bank guarantee from ICICI Bank after availing new limit?
Sir, I had addressed this point. So I said again that is at the time of assessment, the bank would decide what margin in form of a cash margin would be required to utilize the limits. So it could vary, sir, anything between 5, 10, 15, 20, depending on the financials of the borrower, sir.
Okay. I think most of the chat questions
National Secretary, sir, I think you take it up, and if Mr. Krishnan joins, we'll ask him to wait. So before your country emerges, I think he will we'll ask him to ask the question. We'll make him speak.
Yes, thank you. My question to Balbirji. Balbirji, is there any format, particularly of your bank, for this bank guarantee, which may differ to the format of department? In that case, what will be the solution?
Sir, we do not have any such format. Whatever format you provide, basis that only the BG would be issued. Sir, in case there are certain clauses, like earlier sir had asked, Gautam sir had asked that onerous clauses and all, then there would be some additional documentation or a margin related requirement. But there is no text that we provide. Whatever you provide only, sir, we go by that text only. And that text may have certain onerous clauses, onerous or something that actually would call for some legal action at some point of time, or would actually take the exposure more than what actually we have specified. So there could be, to give an example, there is a interest payment clause for any delayed payment. So that actually would call for some additional margin. So the text is what you provide, Pradeep sir. We go by your text. We do not we do not have any text that we provide you so that it is being used. So no standard text, sir. It is whatever, because every entity has got their own formats. We go by the text provided by the applicants.
Some banks give marginal discount against the securities given to you. Particularly, facilities are given by the banks to a particular customer or their customer looking to his credentials with your bank. Is such facilities with you? Because suppose I took a sanction for bank guarantee up to 5 crores, fulfilling all your requirements. In that case, how much margin you are offering to your customer?
So, yeah, again, sir, this is a credit-linked question, sir. I'm not the appropriate person to answer it, but it is all dependent to your financials, sir. How good or bad is your financials basis that the credit team takes a call, and that's where the margins are decided, what is the margin that needs to be kept. So I had mentioned earlier also, sir, it's a credit call, and that would be done by the credit team, sir.
But that will be decided before taking the bank guarantee?
Right. No, sir. That would be at the time of sanction stage only. There is a CAL that would be given. That is the credit arrangement letter. Once you accept the CAL, only the limits are set up. So once the credit arrangement letter is offered, in that all terms and conditions related to the facilities are mentioned in the CAL, you accept it, and that's how it moves to the next stage of sanctioning limits. So at that point of time, you find that the margins specified are higher. There is a scope to check with the bank and ask what can the best possible margin charges, all that are there. It will be specified in the credit arrangement letter. You can look at that before accepting it. And once you find that there is some scope to change the bank also, you can discuss with the bankers. And that is what gets approved as a sanctioned note.
What type of collateral securities you are expecting from client? Immovable properties can be collateral security.
Right, sir. Immovable property is considered as a collateral security. Also, we look at other forms like mutual funds also are accepted. Bonds are also accepted. Deposits. So all this can be looked at. And mutual funds, when I say debt mutual funds, is what we accept. And bonds of certain government departments. So all that can be considered as a securities.
Is there any special scheme your bank is coming for government contractors? Actually, what happens, my association is the maximum members are government contractors. They require bank guarantee, particularly on day-to-day basis even. In that case, how will it be possible for you to issue that bank guarantee within 3 hours? Because as stated by you and as the procedure, particularly digitized procedure to follow that, it will be very difficult for a customer to complete his activities within that 3 hours.
Your first question, sir, is there any specific product available to the contractor segment, sir? In terms of bank guarantee, I would say there is no specific product, but we have something called a GEM account, which I had shown you also, that is exclusive for a government contractor. wherein we offer a zero balance, no MAB account. That is one of the main feature of that. Apart from that, there are host of other features that the account carries. So that is one question of yours, sir. The second question that you were asking was on issuance within the defined turnaround time of 3 hours. So here, sir, once you initiate it online or you submit the documents online, it, provided your limits are sanctioned, I'm not, the 3 hour turnaround time is not for the sanctioning period is not taken into that. So once your limits are sanctioned for bank guarantee, after the limits are set up in the system, you give a request, then the turnaround time starts from there, and that we define it as a 3 hour turnaround time, not the credit assessment. Then setting up limits, your acceptance, all that is not a 3 hours. So that is it. That setting up limits takes anything between 1 to 2 weeks after your assessment is done. So that is out of this purview of 3 hours. 3 hours is the time that you given a request for issuance of BG from the till the time you take the bank guarantee from the banks.
But when the limits are sanctioned, in that case, it should not take much of time, no?
Yeah, once limit is sanctioned, sir, I'm saying you raise a request online or you give a request at the branch, the BG would get issued in the defined turnaround time, sir. Unless there are certain clauses which in the sanctioned terms it is not mentioned. So there they may call for some changes that may get delayed. But otherwise, the BG can be issued in the defined tax.
But in the present pandemic situation, when you are working with less 50% staff, will it be possible for you to follow these norms 3 hours?
Sir, because once you raised a request online, no, it doesn't go to the branch, it goes to our operations unit. And from there, the bank guarantee is prepared and the PDF file is passed on to the branch. So there is we have a strong support center operations at 4 locations, at Delhi, Bombay, Hyderabad and Kolkata, which picks up the transaction immediately and processes and pushes the transaction to the branch, sir, the PDF file. So we are able to do it during the pandemic also, sir. We have delivered on our turnaround time in the last financial year also.
What are your present charges for the bank guarantee period? It is on quarterly basis or what?
Sir, again, depends on the bank guarantee is a fixed deposit that is 100% cash margin. So there the pricing would be different. If it is backed by collateral, the charges would be different, sir. It is not a standard pricing. It would vary. But if I have to tell you, sir, the card rates for the bank starts at 1% per annum and it could go up and it can also be negotiated from 1% depending on the volume and value of the bank guarantee, sir.
No, but actually minimum period you are considering. If I want bank guarantee for a month, you will charge for a month or for a year or for 3 months?
It would be on a monthly basis, sir. If you have taken a 1 month bank guarantee, you will be charged for a month. If you're taking it for 45 days, you will be charged for 2 months, sir.
Okay. One minute.
I have received a request from ICICI Bank head office. They would like to conclude in another 5-10 minutes because there is another meeting scheduled for these gentlemen, both of them. So can we, before you go ahead, can we request Mr. Raju Krishnan to ask this question? Nagarkar,
yes,
sir.
Yes, yes. He is a very important man for us. Yes.
Well, can you unmute yourself?
Yes, sir. Everybody is important.
Bully.
Mr. Nagwegar, your question was very much perfect in the line. What are the charges for bank guarantee for against 100% of deposit?
Yeah, sir. That is, I said, the card rate that we start off is at 1%. That can be looked at basis the value of the bank guarantee and the tenor of the bank guarantee, sir.
See this. Nationalized banks, they are giving us bank guarantees. In case of 25%, they are charging 2%. In case of 100%, they are charging at 0.5%. So, is there any reduction than 0.5% in your services to think to come to your bank for business?
Yeah, sir. Rajiv, sir, that can be discussed, sir. I told you card rate is one.
No, no. What is, see, we are very open. See, coming discussion. See, that is again bargaining part. In general, routine when I'm getting from the nationalized banks at the 0.5%, is there any chances that you should charge me less than that 0.5%?
Sir, I said, sir, that can be discussed, sir, depending on the value and the tenor of the bank guarantee charges can be negotiated, sir. If somebody comes and asks me for a lakh rupee bank guarantee and wants a lower, so there we apply the card rate.
No, bank guarantee will be in crores.
Yeah, sir, definitely, sir. We are open to that. We can discuss that, sir. Give us an opportunity.
See, our dealing is with Union Bank and recently with Cosmos Bank also. Cosmos Bank too, see what they did, they are charging 1%, but they are paying additional interest at 1%. In case of 2 crore rupee bank guarantee, I pay them 2 crore rupees deposit as FDR. On that deposit, they are paying me 1% additional and they are charging 1% as bank guarantee charges. So I'm getting it free of cost. In nationalized bank, I'm getting it 0.5%.
So we can look at it, sir. We are open to discussion, sir. You give us an opportunity. We can discuss that and we will offer you better than what the competition is offering, sir.
See, I'm telling you, please don't take otherwise. I'm telling you a very old story of this ICICI Bank. Please don't take otherwise. I got a message that for children, open an account with 500 rupees. My son was in second, third standard. We did that. After some 5 years, we got that message that 500 rupees what you had deposited was less than the requirement and now you have to pay 2000 rupees. They said 10 years back. That made us to turn from ICICI Bank. So really, policy of bank is to charge anyhow customer or to cooperate customer.
No, no, sir. If I have to address your query related to the 500 minimum balance, so that what is today currently defined, it would continue to be there. But in case there is any change, the customer is informed in advance, sir, that this is what would be the change.
Nothing had been done earlier. Chalo, we will not discuss on that.
Sir, Krishnan, unka head office se meko phone aa raha hai.
Chalo, theek hai, done, sir. I got your point.
Through Parmar sir, we'll meet them. Yeah, and other participants who have raised their questions in the chat now, we are sorry, we will not be able to take it. Please send your queries to bi.mumbaicenter@gmail.com. You take it up now. You are concluding before that. So the questions sent by the participants to bi.mumbaicenter@gmail.com will be sent to the speakers. Whatever they reply, we'll send you to all the participants by email. We will compile it and send it properly. And I believe the floor is yours for the query and the concluding remarks. No more questions now. Thank you.
Balbirji, my last query to you is, some banks, particularly our contractors, all contractors, they are not charging even any commission against bank guarantee. Some banks are giving, particularly I'm telling, then Vijaya Bank, which is now Bank of Baroda, they are not charging any charges, bank guarantee charges on the guarantees issued to them. Because what happens, when we are quoting the tenders, then at that time, if we quote to some extent below or plus side, then additional marginal bank guarantee has to be submitted to them. It may be refunded to us next day if we will not be a lowest one, if we will not be a succeeding bidder. In that case, is there any scheme or product of your bank you can come up with as compared to other banks? Yes, sir. Hey, Madhu, you are disturbing us. You unmute yourself. Yeah. Yes, Balbirji, please unmute. Balbirji, please unmute yours. You got me, no?
Sir, I got your point, sir. Suppose when you come and surrender the bank guarantee, you have taken a bank guarantee for a period of 3 months. You come and surrender it of the fifth day, sixth day. So only 1 month commission is charged. So the balance 2 months commission is refunded back.
But other banks have given us a facility, particularly to all contractors. They are not charging for such cases because we have to complete the procedure.
May agreed, sir. So there is a cost, certain cost of the transaction to the bank. So that is where certain percentage of that is being retained, and whatever is prepaid portion gets refunded, sir. Definitely not free of cost, sir. ICICI Bank would not offer anything that would be a free of cost. Then you compromise on quality, sir. So that is where
they. What quality it differs? Issuance of bank guarantee. What quality it requires?
No, it is not.
You are taking 100% collateral security, etc. You are having with. Then what quality it differs?
So I meant by quality, sir, the facility to apply online, the facility to collect it from the branch without actually doing multiple rounds, the facility to take a bank guarantee late at the evening. So there are certain features is what I'm trying to tell.
Balbirji, to be very frank with you, don't take me otherwise. When we are sending our employee to the bank with the bank guarantee well typed on the particular stamp paper and send to the bank, we are getting our bank guarantee within an hour or so.
Right, sir.
So that's such though no, even 3 hours. I'm telling you, particularly for me, in my whole life, now I have literally 40 years. For bank guarantee, I don't have any problem with my bank. I'm getting it even just on a call. I'm sending my man, I'm getting it.
I agree, sir. That is
in that case.
Yeah, so that is the relationship you enjoy with your banker. They stamp it and they send it across back to you. So that is the process certain PSU banks follow. Whatever you send.
It is not PSU, sir. No, it is Nationalized Bank. I'm talking about
a nationalized bank only. So that is where they would actually stamp it on that same paper what you have sent and hand it over back to you, sir. So
No. They are sending also letters to the client. We are sending this bank guarantee to you. Please confirm. The all procedures they are doing. But we are getting, because what happens, I'm just telling you, we are in hurry of putting our offers to the department. And if it is decided by us, Baba, I have to quote tomorrow's tender, then against that, by knowing the actual my working, because till by I am come to know to my working, then only I can decide what much amount I will have of a bank guarantee I will be requiring. Then I just get it type, format is ready, and send it to bank, and I am getting that bank guarantee within an hour or so, even less than that. Well, okay, if it is, but think on this, I'm not taking a lot much time. I'm coming to the concluding, friends.
Yes, sir, please, thank you.
This is, Mumbai Centers, this lecture series, this is 17th lecture of this year, 21-22. This is a good trend we have set. We are carrying out this, taking this lecture series on various subjects related to our industry. Today's webinar, how to avail bank guarantee in just 3 hours. It is very much informative, knowledge sharing. I'm very much thankful to Balbir Singh ji, particularly you, Mr. Riaz Alam ji. You have given very, very, very informative knowledge regarding the issuance of bank guarantee, and particularly the product available with your bank in relation to the bank guarantee. You also explained what is bank guarantee, FD backed bank guarantee, process of bank guarantee insurance, benefit of GEM current account, etc. Very nicely. It was a good information for us. In second session regarding import transactions, Riaz Alam sir has also given good information, particularly use of trade online platform and its features, details of movement of transactions, real-time tracking on dashboard, outward remittance with its features, online bill, bill of entry regularization, availability of personalized services through their dashboard, very informative, very much encouraging also. Most of our contractors may think of having hand with your bank, and I also expect the suggestions made by us will be taken in good manner, and I think proper justice to our requirements will be given by you people. I once again hereby thanks to all of particularly all ICICI Bank, and I'm concluding here with.
Yeah.
Yes, Madhu.
Yeah, Mr. Nalapani, sir, the vote of thanks, please.
Thank you,
that's
Pradeep Nadu, National Secretary of BIA, for giving his concluding remarks. Now I request Nalapani to give vote of thanks.
Good evening and thanks to all participants. Balveer Singh ji, also Neerav Parmar ji, and Chairman Sri, Chairman Sir, Mohinder Rijwani ji. Thank you for your guidance and give us some knowledge for how to get the banker's guarantee in shortest period. Once again, I thanks to all guests. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Parin, sir. I think Balveer Singh ji, I have been receiving calls from your head office.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody. And I am unmuting everybody. Everybody can unmute themselves. And exchange pleasantries. Balveer Singh ji, it was a nice having you. Surely we will take this. I think Mr. Alok is there.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, then.
Yeah, Mr. Alok, do we have Mr. Alok here?
Godrej ka rate diya usne.
Acha, Alok is not there.
I'm there, sir. I'm there.
Thank you, Mr. Alok, for coordinating. Since the last 15 days, we have been coordinating and setting up.
So much for your support and cooperation, sir.
Thank you very much. Chairman, sir, shall I call you?
Vice President suggested this.
Alok ji, Balveer ji, Riyaz ji, whatever our suggestions have been there.
We will definitely. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
ICICI Bank once again.
Thank you. I think we have another meeting lined up.
Thank you, Mr. Balveer.
अगला सेशन 3 hours की जगह 1 hour का होना चाहिए.
Very Neerav Parmar sir. अच्छा he's.
Thank you, Mr. Balveer. Thank you.
Mr. Balveer, thanks. It was nice interacting with you.
Our pleasure, sir. Thank you for giving the opportunity.
And do look forward for another session with bill discounting. I think that is our hottest topic.
Yeah. We have noted that, sir. We will come back to you on that, sir.
Please come back on that. I think that should be adding a lot of value for all the contractors.
Definitely. Alok, you are hearing now, Alok?
Yes, sir, I have noted that down.
Please. Achha, you have come as Amit Pandey. Achha, okay. I think I'll call it a evening. We have to catch hold of the traffic.
Okay, thank you.
I think ICICI team can leave. We can hang on for another 5 minutes.
Okay.
Hello to us, all of us.
You are in your vehicle now. हमको भी vehicle में बैठना है.
I already left from Colaba now.
I know that. हमको भी बैठना है.
Thank you, sir. We take your leave, sir.
Be safe, everybody. Take care of your health.
Thank you. And let's catch up physically.
Subramani sir, good evening. Randhir boy,
sir. Namaskar, hai kidhar sir?
Fine.
कल्याण
सिटी के अंदर जा रहे
थाना
में है क्या सुब्रमण्यम
यस सर Mr. Pabar, when you are making it live.
Pardon?
State Chairman, sir.
You are giving an opportunity to meet personally.
Yes, sure.
Subrani sir, can we have our physical meeting at your place in this pandemic?
See, Krishnani ji has told that I don't know about meeting, but we can definitely meet for dinner sometime.
No, that is a different thing.
Krishnani sir.
सर बोलिए या
नहीं मैं बोला आपने बोला था कि बाकी कुछ करे ना करे वी कैन डेफिनेटली मीट अप फॉर डिनर
यस यस आई एम ऑलवेज विद यू
ओके
वेयर टू मीट
एनीवेयर वेयर देयर यू वांट
मेरे को और राघव गार सबको बहुत नजदीक है कृष्ण जी साहब
आई हैव जस्ट लेफ्ट फ्रॉम कोलाबा सो इट इज आउट ऑफ क्वेश्चन फॉर मी बट वी कैन प्लान इट आउट नेक्स्ट टाइम
मुझे कभी भी बैंक गारंटी के लिए प्रॉब्लम आया नहीं मेरे बैंक अरे बाबा नागवेकर के अच्छा ही ट्रीटमेंट मिलता है नागवेकर बहुत अच्छा है
सर गलत बोल
रहा है आगे से नागवेकर बैंक गारंटी मांगी है
अरे इतने में
नागवेकर की गाइडलाइन पे आगे फॉलो करने को बोल रहा हूँ
इट डिपेंड्स ऑन पर्सन टू पर्सन नो दे
वी आर ऑल ब्रदर्स बाबा
अरे आई एम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पर्सन फॉर माय बैंक
नहीं आई थिंक कृष्णानी जी ये बोल रहा है कि नेक्स्ट वेबिनार शुड बी कंडक्टेड बाय मिस्टर नागवेकर एंड टेल हाउ इट इज डन इन वन आवर
अरे दैट वेबिनार नॉट रिक्वायर्ड ओनली डिनर आवर आर इनफ फॉर दैट कृष्णा जी बहुत दिन से मिले नहीं है
सबको अनम्यूट का राइट दे दिया
बहुत दिन से मिले नहीं यार कभी तो मिलना मांगता है अभी बहुत हो गया
जल्दी
कभी आ रहे हैं थाना कभी आ रहे हैं
थाना से तो अभी निकला हूँ
अभी थाना से तो निकले
थाना में ही है पकड़ो उनको
थाना में नहीं मैं थाना में नहीं है मेरे पीछे देखो क्या है
वो कल्याण से निकले हैं अभी
नेक्स्ट वेडनेसडे थाना सब मिलते हैं
नेक्स्ट
वेडनेसडे थाना चलो
Yes, sir. सांगलीकर आले आपल्यामध्ये
अरे
सांगलीकरांनी काय बोलले नाही आज त्यांचे चांगले हे असतात
क्वेरीज आम्हाला पण वाटलं तुम्ही काय क्वेश्चन पूछता
सर अनफॉर्च्युनेटली काय झालं माझे क्वेश्चन्स होते पण माझ्या समोर एक क्लायंट येऊन बसलेले आणि मी ऑफिसमध्ये बसलेलो तेवढ्या कारणात त्यामुळे मला काही
पाठवून द्या क्वेरीज पाठवून द्या चॅट मध्ये पण काही क्वेरीज त्यांना पाठवून
नाही नाही अरे
क्लायंट बसलेली म्हणतात ते मग बरोबर आहे ना
अरे ते व्हॉट स्वप्निल इज टेलिंग की दो फ्लैट बेच दिया जब आप बिजी दे रहे हैं उतने में तो
अरे नहीं
के साथ तुम क्या बात कर रहे हो
अरे नहीं
हमारा बिजनेस लग जाएगा स्वप्निल
सर लॉकडाउन है हमारे यहाँ क्या बेचेंगे उसमें
सब क्लाइंट को देख के समझ हो गया ऐसा हो गया
हम तो भूल गए क्लाइंट वगैरह क्या रहता है हम तो भूल गए क्लाइंट क्या रहता है
यस सर बहुत अच्छा हुआ लेकिन सर मोहिंदर जी
गुड टाइम या नहीं सच्ची अच्छा हो गया आज
थैंक यू वेरी मच
मधु जी को रिक्वेस्ट
सपोर्ट ऑफ आवर मेंबर्स
यस मधु जी को रिक्वेस्ट है कि वो YouTube पे डालेंगे ना तो हम एक बार पढ़ के उसका
पक्का YouTube पे चला जाएगा
यस 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 सर यस थैंक यू
थैंक यू सपने बाय
लेकिन मधु ऐसा भी करने का अभी एक महीने के बाद ही डालने का, तो लोगों को लाइव देखेंगे नहीं तो सब सोचेंगे ठीक है रिकॉर्डेड वर्जन देख लेंगे ना फटाफट फॉरवर्ड करके देख लेंगे।
सर ऐसा मत
करो, आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट स्वप्ने हिल बट आई एम सेइंग इन जनरल दैट ट्रेंड हो जाता है।
मैं यार मैं भूल जाएगा बाद में, वो मैं डाल देता हूँ अच्छा रहता है वो।
वो रिकॉर्डेड मिल रहा है ना, अवेलेबल है फैसिलिटी, चलो ना यार देख लेंगे।
उससे नॉलेज बढ़ता नहीं है, अपन क्वेश्चन आंसर हो गए ना उससे ही नॉलेज बढ़ता है।
वो एक्शन में रहते हो ना आप, लाइव एक्शन में रहते हो।
यस बराबर, वीपी सर राइट बोल रहे हैं एकदम,
और आप भी बराबर बोला। ये जो बात अभी छेड़ा ना आपने, क्या वो रिकॉर्डिंग इजीली मिलता है इसलिए कोई आता नहीं है। यस
यस,
बहुत परफेक्ट बोला।
वही वही, क्योंकि वो रिकॉर्डिंग का ऑप्शन अवेलेबल है ना, और मधु क्या इमीडिएटली नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग ढकेल देता है, आ गया चलो।
नो नो, नीरो सर, नीरो सर, आई एग्री विद यू, दिस इज अ पॉइंट व्हिच आई वुड लाइक यू पीपल टू गाइड मी ऑन दैट, because you have a point yeah.
जैसे क्या है मालूम है, ये वर्जन पूरा वन मंथ होने के बाद डालो, भूल जाएगा नहीं है, पीपल विल रिमेम्बर इफ दे वांट टू सी।
एंड वी डू ईमेलिंग एंड व्हाट्सएप वीडियो बीइंग पोस्टेड। चेयरमैन सर,
यस यस डेफिनेटली,
बिकॉज़ नो दिस अप्लाइज टू नेशनल हेडक्वार्टर्स का अलग यूट्यूब चैनल है और मुंबई सेंटर का अलग यूट्यूब चैनल है, सो दिस पॉलिसी कैन बी इंप्लीमेंटेड बोथ द प्लेसेस।
बहुत का मालूम नहीं, नेशनल इज अ डिफरेंट मैटर, नेशनल ठीक है, देयर आर अदर थिंग्स, बट एटलीस्ट टू यू नो एनकरेज मोर पीपल टू लॉग ऑन लाइव
एंड इट इंक्रीज देयर नॉलेज नो इफ दे कम इन टाइम।
कृष्ण साहब, नीरो सर का क्या बोलना है, नीरो सर का क्या बोलना है, डालो वीडियो, बट अभी क्या है, सब जो एक्स वाई जेड है, एक आदमी उसको इवेंट देखने का है, उसको मैंने मेरे मंडे को इवेंट है ना, ट्यूजडे को वाला यूट्यूब पे आ रहे हैं और यूट्यूब पे देखते हैं ना।
और दूसरा क्या है कि उसमें फास्ट फॉरवर्ड करके डेढ़ घंटे का इवेंट 20 मिनट में देख के मोकला खत्म हो गया, हाईलाइट देखा।
अरे मैं तो बोलूंगा सर, वो भी करेगा तो बहुत अच्छा है। इफ यू जान दो, मैं अभी आई डोंट वांट टू ओपन फोरम में बोलने का नहीं है। आई
नो वेयर यू आर टू कम
थाना एंड चेंबूर आल्सो,
अपन मिलेंगे तो मैं आपको बताता
हूं। मैं ऑल ओवर, हां
कितने मेंबर्स रुके हैं अभी, ये अपना बातचीत सुनने के लिए कितने लोग हैं?
मैं भी अभी ऑफिस में हूँ।
ये तो मैं इसके लिए वो क्वेश्चन
पीछे पीछे सब फाइल पड़ा है, देख पीछे फाइल
पड़ा
है। अरे ये देख, भगवान भी मेरे पीछे,
भगवान भी है,
बोलना मत।
और देखिए तो कोबरे में ग्लास भी दिख रहा है,
वो तो वो अलग रहता है ना, वो मैं एक्चुअली छुपा रुस्तम हूँ, तुमको नहीं दिखाएगा।
बाबुलनाथ क्रॉस किया अभी,
मिस्टर वेदानंद आल्सो जॉइंड अस फ्रॉम कन्याकुमारी, बट नो आई थिंक ही हैज जस्ट ऑन करके निकल गए। यार हमको भी निकलने का है, चेयरमैन साहब
शंकर, चलो शंकर एंड जॉइंट फ्रॉम कोलकाता,
अर्ली मॉर्निंग टुडे,
कृष्णा साहब मिलते हैं,
चलो चलो ओके
बाय
एवरीबॉडी।
हां बोलो ना
मधु और चेयरमैन, डायरेक्ट घर पे जाना, बीच में कभी रुकना नहीं,
बीच में का
वाइस प्रेसिडेंट को थैंक्स कीजिए।
धन्यवाद सर,
धन्यवाद,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू एवरीबॉडी,
थैंक यू वाइस प्रेसिडेंट।